thank you for coming here. I'm aware of the fact that there was another press conference and you had to rush back from there. So thank you, all of you. I just thought that let me take this occasion to share with you a couple of things. So the first information that I'm going to share with you is regarding the toll tax. As you are aware that the J&K government currently levies toll under the J&K Levy of Tolls Act 1935 on import or export of various items into or from the Union Territory of J&K. A notification wide SRO 70 of 2018 already stands issued in pursuance of subsection 5 of section 3 of the said act. You may also be aware that in 2018, the government had abolished toll posts at Lower Munda in Anantnag and Borehalan Hirpur in District Shupian in order to remove the trade distortion and inequity within the erstwhile state of Jammu and Kashmir. With the imposition of a GST regime, the entire country has now moved towards a one nation, one market, or what is called a one tax regime. Post GST, all barriers to entry or all tariff-based barriers have now been removed. In such a situation, the continuation of any toll tax regime militates against the basic idea of one nation, one tax. Tariff-based import or export of commodities into or from the Union Territory distorts the trade regime. It acts against the overall consumer interest by imposing avoidable costs on them. The imposition of any toll tax not only penalizes consumers by increasing the cost of commodities, it also renders the entire industrial sector uncompetitive due to high input costs. It fosters inefficiencies by unleveling the playing field in the industrial sector. It leads to quality and pricing issues for consumers. The abolition of the toll tax will lead to an annual levy implemented in letter and spirit. Given the above backdrop, it has been decided to abolish toll tax in Jammu and Kashmir, at Lakhanpur and all other posts, including at railway stations and airports, with effect from January 1, 2020. The Finance Department has already issued the necessary orders in this regard. The government of Jammu and Kashmir remains committed to the development of a vibrant, modern, competitive industrial and manufacturing sector. Coming to Kashmir now, December, machine SMS services were enabled on mobile phones in Kashmir in order to facilitate students, scholarship applicants, traders, and different other citizens. Going forward, it has now been decided to further carry the process on, and from the midnight of today, December 31, 2019, SMS services on mobile phones will be fully restored throughout the Valley of Kashmir. You're also aware that the administration operators, government officials, through various internet touch points, nearly 900 such touch points and special counters are functional throughout Kashmir in districts, prominent tourist places, hotels, offices, etc. Nearly 6 lakh people have taken advantage of these touch points. Carrying further the process, it has been decided to restore internet connectivity to all government hospitals with effect from midnight, December 31, 2019. You are also aware that in September this year, the government had introduced a few questions.
हम देखें सिचुएशन वाज वेरी पीसफुल हाँ चार पांच दिन पहले रहा था ट्रबल अगस्त में लेकिन उसके बाद तो यहाँ पे बिल्कुल पीसफुल है people are suffering students are suffering we understand that you have some security concern in kashmir valley but in jammu situation is overall but yahan pe internet aap 2g ya 4g kyun nahi restore kar rahe hain ek dusra jo aaj ek aur bada issue aaya hai us pe bhi main aapka jawab chahunga jo appointments pe jo recruitment rules pe us pe bada hua hai and opposition is
jahan tak internet ka sawal hai main keval itna hi kehna chahunga and I have been saying this I have been repeating again and again that the continuous effort of the government has been to facilitate and move forward as much as possible and as quickly as possible. And ever since the 5th of August, we have been progressing in this direction, both in Jammu and in Kashmir, and we have been moving progressively forward. And I assure you that we will continue to move progressively forward and we'll try to ensure that as much and as quickly as possible, we will facilitate people. Questions?
Some of the political leaders, they have been detained and they have been house arrested. What are the reasons behind, what they have taken as a part of preventive measures?
Dekhi, as far as any such releases or detentions are concerned, I have said earlier and I say so again that any detention, whether it is preventive or otherwise, is a decision which is taken by the local law enforcing agency based on its assessment of the local law and order situation. And the same is being continuously reviewed. You may have heard yesterday that some people were released yesterday. This is again as a result of a local assessment of the situation, a local review of the situation. So whenever the local law and order authorities feel the need, they carry out actions accordingly.